On the 13th of July 2018, President Museveni in a statement said that Ugandans who had paid the 1% mobile money tax be refunded as the 1% levy was passed and signed in error. The telecoms did refund the money to only people who had been charged for making deposits and not every person who used mobile money services.
That money was reversed back only on deposits only. Let me emphasize this. Because they are cutting money when you are paying bill, they are cutting 1% when you are sending money, they are cutting 1% when you are receiving money, they are cutting 1% when you are withdrawing money. So they were cutting money four times.
Kamyuka equally challenges charges on reception of mobile money.
We are saying if you charge someone to receive the money which you have not yet even used, is it fair? What are you charging?
But the infamous 1% is not the only tax government is levying on mobile money.
After sharing the commission between the telecom company, let us say the 90%, because we said the government is charging 10%, so the remaining is 90%. The 90%, I get 50, 45, and the company is getting 45. On my 45, let us assume, the government is deducting 6% WHT withholding tax.
In this financial year, government increased excise duty from 10% to 15% and withholding tax from 6% to 10%. Due to these taxes, people have shunned mobile money services and mobile money agents are now quitting the business due to reduction in transactions. A number of youths are finding employment in mobile money business and their future employment remains in balance if the law is not overturned. I'm Dennis Onyala for Urban TV.